Greetings, all you very rare individuals. Welcome to another Afro Scot podcast. This episode 35, we're going to talk about why African food is great. Specifically, we're going to talk about the origins of plantain. Now, what is plantain? Well, plantain is a fruit, a berry, and a plant. It's closely connected to the banana, but plantain is slightly different in that it's slightly larger and is sweeter and also has a very different taste once it becomes ripe compared to the banana. And also, it's not as soft as the banana. The great thing about the plantain is that it can be mashed, it can be fried, it can be used in cupcakes, it can be used in various different things. It can even be used to make chips, plantain chips, for all those people who know what plantain chips are. They're the next best thing. Now, what I really want to talk about in the plantain is just the origins of it and where it really started. Some people say it started in Southeast Asia, and some people say it started in South America or Africa. Wherever it started, it definitely can only grow in a hot climate. At the time when bananas and plantains were used, it wasn't as global as it is right now. Back in the days, bananas were really just sold at local markets and used locally. They weren't something that was mass produced as they are now. And usually bananas were just a local fruit that people ate just for enjoyment. In Japan, once the plantain got to Japan, they used the plantain fibers to create kimonos, textiles, as I guess the plantains were sturdy. Sometimes they even used the plantain skins as well, not the inside where you get the soft finish. I'm talking about the outside covering, the part that you peel off. They can actually use that as well to put on top of foods as plates, and it actually gives off a very nice aroma and fragrance when the hot oil goes on top of the plantain skin. It just gives off a nice aroma and fragrance. In Nigeria, where I'm from, we fry the plantain and we use it for plantain chips. Plantain is great because it can go with pretty much everything. It can go with beans, it can go with eggs, fried eggs. It can even go with rice. You see them at parties. You can use the plantain to eat many different things. They can go with jollof rice and fried rice as well. They cut them in like tiny circles and they usually taste really, really good. There's just something about the plantain that has just a sweet, nice taste, especially when it's cooked well and it's nice and crunchy in the mouth. And it's like swallow food in a way as well, like the pounded jam. You know, it's not something that requires you to chew for too long. It's not hard or difficult to eat. So that's why it's used many, many times in different Nigerian cuisines, as shown in other images in this podcast. Now, history-wise, it said that Alexander the Great was one of the first people to discover the plantain fruit during his expedition in India, and he seems to have brought it back to Macedonia and somehow made it a staple. And through that, it started to spread around the world through the Portuguese trade, and it got into some places in Africa, and it became a staple in Africa as well, in South America and other hot climates. I find it quite interesting that the food goes all the way back. Many people say that plantain is an African food, or it's a Asian food, or it's a South American food. But what's interesting is that if you actually look back at history, it actually went through quite many different cultures and countries and continents in order for it to be well known. And now it's pretty much global, especially the banana family. However, not many people know too much about plantain. I remember growing up, when I'd mentioned the plantain in schools or with my friends, especially my friends who weren't African, they'll look at me strange. They just couldn't really understand what the plantain was. They thought it was a banana. I told them it was a plantain. They asked me, what does it taste like? And you know, it's quite, in my opinion, it's quite hard to describe what something tastes like, especially if the person has never tasted it before. So I find it really, really strange how when I was growing up, not much people knew about plantain. And you wouldn't really see it in the shops like Tesco, Asda, Sainsbury's, Aldi, at the time we had summer fields, you never really see the plantain there. You'd have to go to the African shops or Kashmir to get plantains. So plantain isn't really something that a lot of Scots really eat, though it's a staple in African cuisine. It's not really something that I've seen much in Scottish cuisine, and that's a shame, because I think as an Afro Scot, if you're looking forward to becoming an Afro Scot and you want to be an Afro Scot, you must be interested in a plantain, because it's part of the culture, it's an integral part of African culture, that type of fruit. Similar to how here they love the haggis, you know, you've got the shortbread, the tablets, you know, there's different types of foods that they heat here, like mashed potatoes is quite common here. And I've eaten mashed potatoes before. I've eaten everything that I mentioned there. But not many Scots have really tried the plantain. And there's many ways to do it. You can use the plantain and soften it, flatten it to create burger patties. You know, you can grill it. There's people that can grill it. You can roast it. You know, there's some people who roast it, and you can get it at the market in Nigeria. If you're actually going down the market where you can get suya, you can actually get roast plantains as well. You can create chips with it to create plantain chips. You can mash it up and create these kind of potato bites or crunches. I don't know what it's really, really called. My mother used to make them quite a lot, and she would mix the plantain in, and it'll be really, really delicious with the peppers and stuff. Some people use it in really fancy ways, and they can use it to kind of put toppings on top of it and create kind of cups. Some people can put it into cupcakes and create banana plantain cupcakes, and I guess that would taste really, really delicious. There's many ways to do plantain stuff. But I'm glad you enjoyed this podcast, and if you're a Scot, listen to this, I urge you, try the plantain if you haven't tried it before. As an African, this is a great part, an integral part of our culture. And by knowing this, it makes us become strong, full-fledged, determined Afro Scots.